Welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. This is another session of sequence and series. I hope you have already watched first session and thereafter any other sessions which have been completed. So today we are going to discuss few questions. And the questions basis on the formula which we have been discussed in the previous classes. The formula that in arithmetic progression we have learned one is Tn term, nth term of the arithmetic sequence, and the second formula that what we have learned is D, how to calculate D. So let us discuss few questions on the basis of that. How can you find D and what will be the relations in Tn term, and how can we evaluate first term, common difference, sometimes any number of terms, sometimes value of n, like that. So a few questions we are going to discuss today, and let us try to understand. First question I am going to take on today: if fifth term of an AP is 34, fifth term of an AP is 34, and its fifth term of an AP is 34, and its 11th term is 64. 11th term is 64. 5th term of AP is 34, and 11th term of an AP is 64. Fine, even I can write here 6th term of an AP is 34, and 6th term of an AP is 34, and 11th term of AP is 64. Find its first term and common difference. This is the very first type of question, and I am going to discuss this from the basics. So that is why this question I have taken, and try to understand the solution. What is the solution of this? We know, what is that? Do you remember that, what I have given? Nth term of an AP, nth term, that is Tn, is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. Do you remember that? Yes, sir. So last class we have discussed this. Nth term of an AP is this. This is the formula. What is A? First term. What is D? Common difference. But we don't know, neither first term of this AP is given, nor common difference of the AP is given. So we have to find that. The other information which has been given here, that the 5th, 6th term and 11th term are given. 6th term of an AP is 34, and 11th term of an AP, that AP is 64. 6th term means in place of n, I can put 6. So 6th term of an AP is A plus 6 minus 1, that is 5D. Right now this is the 6th term. And this is what given? That 6th term of an AP is given 34. It means A plus 5D is equal to 34. This is the equation first. Again, similarly, T11th term of an AP is given, and that is 64. 11th term, that in place of n I can put 11. T11 is equal to A plus 11 minus 1. 11 minus 1 is 10. 10D. So that will be A plus 10D. And what is that? 64. So this is the second equation. If I could subtract second minus first, what will happen? If I would subtract second minus first, A minus A, cancel. 10D minus 5D is 60, and 64 minus 34 is 30, and therefore D is equal to 5. D is equal to 5. Putting the value of D in first equation, now what we'll get? Putting the value of D in equation one or two, anyone of them can be used for putting the value. A plus 5D is equal to 34. This implies A plus 5 into D is also D is 5. A plus 5D is equal to 34. And then what will happen? D is also 5. Here A plus 10D minus 5D is equal to 5D, sorry. And this is 5D, and what will happen? This is 5D, and D is equal to 6. Now if I put here 6, D is equal to 6, then what will happen? 6, 5 is 30, A plus 30 is equal to 34, A plus 30 is equal to 34, this implying A is equal to 34 minus 30, that is 4. So A is equal to 4, and this will be the answer, right? I'm sorry here, 10D minus 5D is 5D, I have written by mistake 6D, so this can happen. Sometimes if you are sleeping mind, somewhere mind is migrated, it can happen. But anyway, you understand this, that 10D minus 5D is 5D, 64 minus 34 is 30, 5D is equal to 30, and D is equal to 6. So D is 6, if I put this value here, then what will happen? A plus 5D is equal to 34, A plus 5 into 6 is 34, A plus 30, 6, 5 is 30, is 34, 30 will come this side, it will be subtracted, because it is positive this side, it will be negative this side, so 34 minus 30 is 4. So what we have to calculate? Find the first term, that is A, and common difference, that is D. And we have calculated both. Common difference and first term, both have been calculated. So this question is complete. Right? Let me write another question of the similar pattern. If seventh term of an AP is 53. Seventh term of an AP is 53. And 13th term of an AP is 101, right? Find its 19th term. This is the question. Now, I have to deal with this question. Again, here first term is not given, neither first term is given, nor common difference is given. But what is given here? That 7th term of AP is 53 and 13th term of the same AP is 101. This is the given. And now we have to find 19th term. So, let me start solution. Again, we can write with the same formula. P7 is equal to 53. This employee A plus 6D is equal to 53. Right? Equation first. Similarly, P13 is equal to 101. This employee A plus 12D is equal to 101. Can I write like this? In 13th term, here coefficient of D will be 12. You understand this? We had discussed in the last class as well. And here if you put in the formula, 13 minus 1 is 12, so it will be 12D. So T13 is this, it means coefficient of, in 13th term, coefficient of D will be 12, in 7th term, coefficient of D will be 6. Now again, if I subtract 2nd minus 1st, 2nd minus 1st, what will happen? A cancel, 12D minus 6D is 6D. This implies 6D is equal to 101 minus 53. 11 minus 3 is 48, and 9 minus 5 is 48. So that will be 4, 48. 6D is equal to 48, and therefore D is equal to 8. 48, D will divide this side. 48 divided by 6, that is 8. You got it? Now, putting the value of D in equation first, we get, putting the value of D in equation first, what we'll get? a plus 6d is equal to 53. Now what is a? We don't know, but we know about d, and d is 8, that is 53. So here a plus 48, 6 8 is 48, is equal to 53, and now that can be written as a is equal to 53 minus 48 is equal to what? 5. So value of a is 5. Value of d has been calculated. Value of a can be calculated. This 2 has been derived already. No? And now what is need to find 19th term? 19th term we can find now. This is what we have to find out. 19th term is a plus 18d, and a is nothing else but a is 5, and 18 into d is what? 8. 18 is 144, and 144 plus 5 is 149, and that will be the answer of this question. So I hope you got it, and this is easy enough. We can solve it, right? So such type of question can be solved easily where two relations are given, that is value of two terms, any two terms are given, but we have to find either first term or common difference or any other terms. We can do that. This type of question can be solved easily by using this. So let me discuss some more question, right? Let me write third question. And third question is here. Again in a similar pattern, I am writing here the third question. And third question is something in terms of unknown variable. Like if seventh term of an AP, seventh term of an AP is 7th term of an AP is 38. 7th term of an AP is 38. And 10th term of that AP is 56. Find its 17th term. One more question of the similar pattern I am going to discuss. Or if it is asked that which term will be 115 or like that, but I can write here. Just let me discuss this question, thereafter I do that question as well. Again in the similar fashion, become very faster, bit faster, and 7th term is 38. So you can write a plus 6d is equal to 38, right now? Again, 10th term is 56, so we can write a plus 9d is equal to 56. If you subtract 2nd minus 1st, what will happen? 9d minus 6d, that is 3d, 16 minus 8 is 8, and 4 minus 3 is 18, so d is equal to 6. Now from 1st, one can write it, a plus 6 into 6, that is 36, is equal to 38, and therefore a is equal to 2. Got this? And a is 2 and d is 6. Now we have to find 17th term is equal to a plus 16d. So anybody can solve it only. A is 2 and 16 into 6 is 96. 2 plus 96 is equal to 98, and that is answer. I hope you, if you watch the clock, it is less than 20 seconds required to solve this question. So this type of question, once you understand, you will be able to solve in less than 20 seconds. Once you see the question, you will be able to analyze all those questions, right? So fourth question, let me discuss fourth question. Fourth question of this is, right, question number 4. If 8th term of an AP is 31. 8th term is 31 and 13th term, 8th term is 31 and 13th term is 51. Now question is, 8th term is 31 and this is 107 or term of that AP. This is the question. Is 107 a term of that AP? We don't know whether 107 is that term of not. How can you recognize that? We do not know what is the 107th term of that is in AP or not. So first of all, we will write the solution. 8th term of AP, we can write in school, you will write here, let A be the first term of an AP and D is their common difference. D is the common difference. D is common difference of that AP, right? A is the first term of that AP and D is the common difference. So, 8th term of that AP can be written as A plus 7D and this implies A plus 7D is equal to 31. This is given. T 13 is 51. That can be written as A plus 12D and this implies A plus 12D is equal to, what is this? 51 is given and that is second. Now we can subtract second minus first. Subtracting second minus first, we get, what is that? 12D minus 7D, A minus A cancel, 12 minus 7 is 5, D is equal to 20, D is equal to 4. Now putting in first, we get, what we get? If you put in first, what we get? A plus 7 into 4 is equal to 31, that is A is equal to 31 minus 28 is equal to 3. Now, we have to find whether 107th is any term of this equation or not. So, let Tn term is 107 for some value of n that we don't know, some value of n, right? So, Tn is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. This is Tn. So, I can put here, what is A? 3 plus n minus 1 into d is what? D is 4 is equal to 107. 107 minus 3 is 104. And 104 into 4. 3 will come this side, it will be negative. And 4 in that side, it will be divide. So that is 26. So n is equal to 27. Yes. If the value of n will come as integral value, it means 27th term of this AP is 107. Suppose n should not come or would not come, would have been come in fraction, then it means this term do not exist, right? So n is 27, it means what? 27th term of that AP is 107. So what was the question? Is 107 a term of that AP? Yes, 107 is term of that AP. And which term? That 27th term. If someone asks which term, we can say 27th term. So I hope you got it, right? So this type of question can be dealt with using this concept, using the formula, what we have learned, that Tn is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. I hope you got it. So keep watching the video of Arvind Singh Academy and please share and subscribe the videos of different subjects as well. We are going to discuss in the next video some different type of questions. Thank you very much.